We're back to our Winston drawing program, but I've added some text to it. See, what I want to do is position a Winston underneath each of these labels to show him at each point in life. But right now, he's all over the place. That's because we're setting the face X and the face Y to random numbers inside the function. Instead, what we want to be able to do is say, hey, here's the exact position I want you to draw this Winston at, and then I want to be able to specify that position every time I call the function. The same way we do with ellipse and rect, right? Because I want to be able to put a Winston here, and a Winston here, and a Winston here, and a Winston here. And I don't want just random places every time I call the function. So in order to do that, we have to specify parameters for the function, both in our function definition at the top here, and in our function call down here when we actually call it. So for draw Winston, we want to pass it face X and face Y and have it use those values that we pass in instead of generating them randomly. Let's start off by thinking about what we'd pass into these function calls down here. We want to position the Winstons under each bit of text, so we'd probably want the X and Y of each Winston to be really similar to the numbers we passed into the text functions. Maybe just 10 pixels lower in the Y. So maybe the first one would be 10 and 30, and then maybe 200, 230, 10, 230, 200, 230. It's the same as the text coordinates. I'm just adding 10 to each Y because I want it just a little bit lower. Okay, but Winston hasn't moved. That's because we haven't told our function up here that we're passing it parameters. So it's still using these random values. So in order to tell this function that, hey, we're going to give you this information instead, we have to give the parameters names inside these parentheses. So we'll call it face X and face Y and separate from comma. And we're going to call it that because that's what we're already using to refer to them inside the function, right? So that way we don't have to rewrite the rest of our code. But still, nothing has happened. Winston is still all over the place. Well, if you look at the very top of our function, we're overwriting face X and face Y with random values still. So all we have to do is delete these lines. Ta-da! And now face X and face Y are getting passed into the function, and it's using the values that we're calling it with here. Now, as you can see, I didn't quite position Winston correctly because I forgot that text gets positioned according to the upper left and the face gets positioned according to the center. So I really just need to go and tinker with my numbers a little bit here, right? So probably I need to move the X over a lot. I need to move this over. Okay. So that's our toddler. We'll go through. And now all I have to do is change what I'm passing into the function. I don't have to change the function definition at all because it's always going to take whatever values we pass in. Right? Just like with ellipse and rect. Okay, so I've kind of positioned it, but what I've noticed is that Winston is too big. He's overlapping, he doesn't fit. Well, since I put all of the code to draw him in a function, I can change the size of all of them at once just by changing one line of code that draws the ellipse. So let's say if we make him like 190, yeah, Winston's going on diet by 190. Very nice. Okay, so now he's going to fit a lot better, and then you know, I could keep tweaking so I could actually get him inside there, right? Cool. So let's do a final review of what this code does. It defines a function called drawWinston, and it says that this function takes two values, and it labels them face X and face Y. And these values basically come in as variables that we can use anywhere inside our function, just like we used to use the variables that we declared at the top. And then we can call this function whenever we want after we declare it, and we can pass in different values so that it'll use those new values each time. So now you've seen what's really cool about functions. We can come up with code that we think would be really useful to reuse, but we can also use parameters to say, hey, here's a little something you can change about this code to customize it. It's like a recipe. You write down the general instructions, and you realize you suddenly need to feed four Winstons instead of one. You don't have to start all over. You just modify the original instructions and multiply everything by four. So now you can start thinking about the recipes in your code. Yummy.